See that beautiful sunset over Lake Como? That's our planet. Now imagine this, countless Earths, each one its own universe, repeating over and over in a cosmic loop. Feeling a little dizzy? You aren't alone. Welcome to the multiverse, where reality isn't just one story, but a never-ending chain of possibilities. Today, we're going to dive into five of the most insane multiversal theories that scientists have proposed to explain the nature of our universe and the countless others that may exist out there. These theories attempt to explain not just the nature of our universe, but the existence of countless others. Now, consider this. What if you're living not just one life, but an infinite number of lives, each one mirroring the last? It sounds like a plot twist from a sci-fi novel, but it's a theory that some scientists believe could be our reality. But before we dive into the deep end of the cosmic theories, let's start with something a bit closer to home. Fasten your seatbelts, grab your popcorn, and let's embark on this journey through the multiverse. So, what's a multiverse in simple terms? Well, it's a collection of potentially infinite universes, including our very own. These universes aren't squabbling over the last slice of cosmic pizza. Instead, they're each living out their own unique laws of physics and possibly even their own versions of reality. It's like a cosmic buffet with an endless variety of dishes. There are several theories about how this multiverse might function. First up is the inflationary multiverse theory. This theory suggests that during the Big Bang, different regions of space-time expanded at different rates, creating separate bubbles or universes. Imagine each bubble as a separate universe, each with its own unique story like a cosmic soap opera with infinite episodes. But what if these bubbles play by different rules? Imagine a bubble where gravity pushes instead of pulls, or where time runs backward. That's where the string theory multiverse comes into play. According to string theory, everything in the universe is made up of tiny, vibrating strings. I know that makes no sense, but think of it like this. You probably know that atoms are made up of smaller particles, protons, neutrons, and electrons. Traditional physics tells us that these particles are point-like, meaning they don't have any physical size. They're just tiny points with mass and charge. However, string theory proposes a different idea. Instead of being point-like, it suggests that these particles are actually tiny, one-dimensional strings. And just like guitar strings, these tiny strings can vibrate in different ways. Each unique vibration corresponds to a different particle, with its own distinct properties like mass and charge. So the variety of particles we observe in the universe, from quarks to electrons, could all be the result of different vibrational patterns of these fundamental strings. So in string theory, each unique way of vibrating or note corresponds to a different physical law. Therefore, each universe could be like a different song, played with the same strings but with different notes, creating a unique cosmic symphony. Now, are you ready to pop these bubbles of reality? Let's dive deeper into more multiversal theories. But before we do, what do you think about these theories? Do you find them as confusing as a complex puzzle or as clear as a summer's day? Share your thoughts as we continue our journey. All right, now that we've dipped our toes into the cosmic ocean of the multiverse, let's dry off a little and ask a fundamental question. What's the difference between a universe and a multiverse? Well, think of it like this. A universe is like a single book. It has a beginning and end, and a whole lot of interesting stuff in between. Kind of like your favorite mystery novel. Now, a multiverse, on the other hand, is like a library filled with an infinite number of books. Each book is a universe, with its own unique story, characters, and plot twists. But why does this matter? Why do some scientists prefer the idea of a multiverse over a single universe? Well, it's kind of like choosing between having one ice cream flavor forever or having an infinite variety of flavors to choose from. If we live in a single universe, we need to explain why it has the specific properties it does. Why these laws of physics? Why this amount of dark energy? It's like asking why vanilla is the only flavor available. However, if we accept the concept of a multiverse, these questions change. Instead of asking why our universe is the way it is, we start asking why we find ourselves in this particular universe instead of another. It becomes a shift from a physics question to a more philosophical one, kind of like choosing between a scoop of ice cream or pondering the nature of dessert itself. Now let's take this a step further. Remember that library that was filled with countless books, each representing a different universe. What if I told you that all these books are being read simultaneously? Welcome to the concept of parallel universes. Imagine you're at a crossroads. One path leads to a city, the other to a beach. In our everyday experience, you can only pick one. But in the world of quantum mechanics, you could take both. Imagine having your cake and eating it too, except you're splitting into two versions of yourself, each experiencing a different outcome. Now, apply this idea to every choice, every quantum event, every interaction for everything in the universe. The result? An unimaginably vast number of parallel universes, all existing simultaneously. In this scenario, there's a universe where you're a rock star, another where dinosaurs never went extinct, and yet another where pineapple on pizza is universally loved. The possibilities are literally endless. Talk about an all-you-can-imagine buffet of realities. But before you start planning your inter-universal tour, remember that this is just one interpretation of quantum mechanics, known as the many-worlds interpretation. It's a mind-bending idea that sparked countless sci-fi stories, but it's also a serious scientific proposal. Some physicists believe it could explain the weirdness of the quantum world, kind of like explaining why socks always disappear in the laundry. It's strange, but there might just be a reason for it. Now let's peel back the layers of the quantum realm. This world, with all its weirdness, serves as the secret sauce in a cosmic recipe of multiverse theories. First on our list is quantum superposition. This is the idea that a particle can be in multiple states at once. A famous thought experiment to illustrate this is Schrödinger's cat. In this scenario, a cat is placed in a box with a radioactive atom that has a 50% chance of decaying and killing the cat. According to quantum mechanics, until we open the box and observe the cat, it exists in a superposition of states. It's both alive and dead at the same time. It's only when we open the box and observe the cat that the superposition collapses and the cat becomes either alive or dead. This might sound bizarre, but it's a fundamental aspect of the quantum world. Now let's take this concept a step further. In the context of the multiverse, each state of the cat, alive or dead, could correspond to a different universe. So when we open the box in our universe and find the cat alive, there's another universe where we opened the box and found the cat dead. It's like different episodes of a quantum drama series, where each episode explores a different outcome of the same scenario. Next, we encounter quantum entanglement, another fascinating principle in quantum mechanics. It's a bit like having a pair of magical dice. When you roll these dice, no matter how far apart they are, they always show the same number. This is because they're entangled. A change to one instantly affects the other, even if they're on opposite sides of the world. In the context of the multiverse, some scientists speculate that these entangled particles might be connected through different universes. It's as if each die exists in two places at once, here in our universe and also in another parallel universe. So when you roll the die here, it's also rolled in the other universe, and both outcomes are the same. This is just a theory, but it's one of the ways that quantum mechanics could potentially serve as gateways to parallel universes. Now, do you remember the crossroads we discussed earlier? This is a perfect analogy for the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, also known as the quantum multiverse theory. In this theory, every decision or event creates a split in the universe. Each split forms a new universe, a new reality, where a different choice was made or a different outcome occurred. So let's say you're deciding between having an apple or an orange for a snack. In our normal understanding, you'd choose one, and that's it. But in the many worlds interpretation, the moment you make a choice, the universe splits into two, one where you chose the apple, and another where you chose the orange. Each of these universes is just as real as the other and continues on its own path, independent of the others. This happens for every decision, every possibility, for every particle in the universe. Like an ever-branching tree of universes, each branch representing a different outcome. So in this view, all possible alternate histories and futures are not just theoretical. They exist in their own separate universes. It's a strange concept, but it's one of the ways scientists try to make sense of the strange world of quantum mechanics. However, before you start worrying about bumping into your quantum replica, remember that these are just interpretations of quantum mechanics. They're like different flavors of ice cream, all delicious, but still subjects of ongoing debate about which one is the best. As we continue our journey through the multiverse, bear in mind that in the realm of quantum mechanics, things are rarely as they seem. Now that we've had a good look at the quantum world and peeked into parallel universes, let's consider a new idea. What if our universe was just repeating itself over and over again from the Big Bang to the eventual end of the universe back to the Big Bang, like a cosmic chain? This brings us to the concept of a chain of universes. Imagine a necklace, each bead representing a universe. Some beads are similar to each other, like identical twins, while others are wildly different, like a cat and a toaster. This necklace is infinite, stretching in both directions without end. This is the idea of a chain of universes. but why a chain? Well, some theories suggest that universes can give birth to other universes, like a cosmic family tree, with each universe spawning child universes, which in turn spawn their own children, and so on. Now, here's a thought. What if in this infinite chain of universes, we are living the same lives over and over again? It's a weird concept, isn't it? Some theories suggest that in an infinite multiverse, every possible event will occur an infinite number of times. This means that there could be universes where you're living the exact same life you're living now. But what are the implications of this idea? On one hand, it could mean that our choices don't matter, as every possible outcome of our decisions is playing out somewhere in the multiverse. On the other hand, it could give our lives a sense of infinite possibility, as every choice we make creates a new universe. Think of it like every decision is a cosmic lottery ticket. With that concept in mind, let's rewind the cosmic VHS tape and ask a question that has puzzled scientists for decades. What happened before the Big Bang? Traditionally, the Big Bang is seen as the beginning of everything. Time, space, matter, energy. But what if there's a prologue? What if there was something before the Big Bang? Consider it the same as finding out that your favorite movie has a prequel. This is a controversial idea. Some scientists argue that asking what happened before the Big Bang is like asking what's north of the North Pole. It's a bit like asking what's before the start of a movie. According to the theory of general relativity, time and space began at the Big Bang, so there's no before to speak of. But other theories suggest that our universe could be just one chapter in a much larger story. For example, some theories related to the multiverse suggest that our universe could be just one in a chain of universes, each one born from the death of a previous universe. In this view, the Big Bang was not the beginning, but a transition from a previous universe to our own. And then there's the idea of a cyclic universe, where the universe goes through endless cycles of expansion and contraction. In this view, the Big Bang was just the latest in an infinite series of cosmic bounces like a cosmic yo-yo. These theories could radically change our understanding of the universe and the nature of time itself. Instead of a linear arrow, time could be a loop or a cycle, endlessly repeating. So, what does the future hold for research into the multiverse? Well, if we knew that, we'd probably be in a different universe where we can predict the future. Jokes aside, the field of multiversal research is still in its infancy, but it's growing faster than a toddler on a sugar rush. With advances in technology and theoretical physics, we may soon be able to test some of the fascinating theories we discussed today. One promising area of research is the principle of holography. Now, this isn't about those shiny stickers you used to collect as a kid. This concept suggests that our 3D universe can be projected from data stored on a 2D surface, much like a hologram. If this turns out to be true, it could open up new ways of studying the universe and even provide evidence for the existence of other holographic universes. Imagine being able to read the data of another universe, or to detect the echoes of a universe that existed before our own, like a cosmic archaeologist digging through the sands of time and space. But with these potential discoveries come big questions. What would it mean for our understanding of reality if we found evidence of other universes? Would it make us feel small and insignificant, or would it inspire us to explore and understand our universe? And what new questions would it raise? So, as we continue to explore the multiverse, remember to keep an open mind. After all, in a parallel universe, you might be the one explaining this to me. But what an amazing adventure it's been! We've traversed the concept of an infinite chain of universes, unlocked the enigmas of quantum mechanics, questioned the existence of a time before the Big Bang, and even had a glimpse into the future of multiversal research and how these theories could change our understanding of reality, from the nature of time to the very fabric of the universe's existence itself. But remember, these are just theories. They're ideas that push the boundaries of our understanding and challenge us to think in new ways. Now it's your turn. I have a question for you. If you could visit any parallel universe, where would you go and why? Would you choose a universe where you're a rock star or one where dinosaurs never went extinct? Share your thoughts in the comments below. And that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this journey through the multiverse, please give this video a like and share it with your friends. And if you want to join us on future journeys through the universe, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. Feel free to leave a comment below about what you're curious to learn more about. Whether it's an in-depth dive of one of the latest advancements of multiversal research, the mysterious dark energy, the intriguing quantum entanglement, or any other cosmic secret, we'd love to hear from you. Your questions and interests could inspire our next journey through space. Until then, keep exploring, stay curious, and remember, in the multiverse, anything is possible. See you next time.